Hello students, how are you? I hope all of you are safe at home. Okay, let's start the chapter 6, inequalities. What do you mean by inequalities? First, you should know what are equations. Then you should understand inequalities. Equations are two equality statements. In equations, there are two sides, left hand side, right hand side. Both sides must be same. But inequalities, both sides, left hand side, right hand side, need not to be equal. It may be greater than or smaller. Let us suppose I am going to market with 200 rupees. I have 200 rupees. I want to buy rice. The cost of rice of 1 kilogram packet is 30 rupees. The rice is available only in the form of packet, 1 kilogram packet, and the cost of each packet is rupees 30. Then the money spent by me will be in 200 rupees. How many packets should I buy? Let us suppose the number of packets is x. In algebraic form, I am stating. Let us suppose the number of packets is x. Then, since the cost of each packet is rupees 30, then total money spent by me is 30x. This 30x will be less than 200. Okay, this 30x, this is the spending by me, and this would be less than 200 rupees. It will not exceed because I have only 200 rupees. This is inequality. This is not equal. This is not an equation. This is an equality. Let us suppose an Reshma is going to market to buy registers and pens with 102 rupees, 120 rupees. Reshma is going to market with 120 rupees. 120 rupees. The cost of each register, the cost of one register is rupees 40 rupees. And the cost of one pen is rupees 20. Cost of one register is 40 rupees. Cost of one pen is 20 rupees. Let us suppose the number of registers is x. Number of registers is x bought by the Reshma. Bought by Reshma. Then spending on register will be 40x. And now the cost of one pen is rupees 20, and the number of pens bought by Reshma is y. Then total cost of y pen is 20y rupees. Now total cost, total spending by Reshma, 40x plus 20x, and this will be less than 120 rupees, or it may be equal, 40x plus 20y equal to 120. Then this is called inequality, and this is called equation, because this, in this केस बोथ साइड्स आर इक्वल, इन दिस केस बोथ साइड्स आर नॉट इक्वल। नाउ the if ax plus b, ax plus b this is greater than 0, this is called inequality in one variable because x is one variable. This is inequality ax plus b greater than or equal to 0. This is called inequality in equality. This is also called in equality. Then what is the difference between these two equalities? The difference is this is strict inequality. This is strict inequality and this is slight inequality, slight inequality. This is strict inequality and this is called slight inequality. If ax plus by greater than 0, this is called inequality in two variables because x and y, there are two variables. If ax square plus bx plus c greater than 0 or this slight inequality, this is called quadratic inequality equations. This is called quadratic inequality equations. Understood? Now there is a question, how we should solve it? How we should solve it? In solving the equations, we shall apply the rules of transformation. Both the sides will be multiplied by the same number. Both the sides will be divided by the same number. Both the sides will be added by the same number. Both the sides will be subtracted by the same number. But in equality, there are some certain rules. Rule number one. Both sides will be subtracted by the same number. Both the sides will be added by the same number. Let us suppose here 3x plus 2, here minus 2. Both the sides will be added by the same number. If I add plus 2 in this side, we will add in this side also. Rule number 2. Both the sides will be subtracted by the same number. Let us suppose 3x plus 2, 4. Both the sides will be subtracted by the same number. Let us suppose minus 2 in this side, minus 2 in this side also. Rule number 3. Both sides will be multiplied by the same number. Let us suppose 3x plus 2 equal to 2. Multiply by 2 in this side also. Both the sides will be multiplied by the same number. Both the sides will be divided by the same number. Let us suppose 3x plus 2 upon 3. Let us suppose. Both the sides will be divided by the same number. Let us suppose I am dividing by 2. 3x plus 2 by 2 by 2. But rule number 4 is some different. Rule number 4 is some different. Let us suppose 3x plus 2 greater than 2. If it is multiplied by the negative number means minus 2 in this side, minus 2 in this side, then after multiplication the inequality sign means what? This minus 2 3x plus 2 will change, minus 2 minus 4. This inequality sign will change. If multiplying by negative number, then inequality sign will change. If 3x plus 2 greater than 2, if divided by negative number, minus 2, minus 2, negative number, minus 2, minus 2, both the sides, the inequality sign will change, means minus 3x plus 2 upon 2, this inequality sign will change in this side, minus 1. Overall, both sides can be added by the same number. Both sides can be subtracted by the same number. Both sides can be multiplied by the same number. Both sides can be divided by the same number. But both sides can be multiplied by negative number. Then the inequality sign will change. Both the sides can be divided by the negative number, but inequality sign will change. This will change. Okay. Now I am going to solve some questions. Questions are example number 2. How is x minus 3 less than 3x plus 1? When 1 is x is a real number, number 2 is x is an integer, you have to solve. Conditions are number 1, x is a real number and x is an integer. I am writing this 5x minus 3 less than 3x plus 1. First of all, here minus 3 will be removed. Minus 3 will be removed, therefore 5x minus 3 plus 3 less than 3x plus 1 plus 3. Here 3 and 3 both sides are added. x less than 3x plus 4, this will become 4. Now in this side, from in this side, 3x can be removed, then I can write it as 5x minus 3x, 3x minus 3x plus 4. This will become 2x less than 4, x less than 2, x less than 2. Now discuss about x less than 2. X is less than 2. X will not include 2, but x is less than 2 means, less than 2 means what? It will be minus 1, 0, 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 2, and so on. This is the solution. This is the solution of second. This is the solution of second. Integer. This is integers. Therefore, x belongs to that minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1. This is the solution of x is an integer, second solution. Now, I am going to discuss about the solution of 1. X is a real number. In here I have found that x is less than 2. Real number means what? 2 less than 2 means it will not include 1. It will not include 2. Less than 2 means 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. This is an integer. This is a natural number. This is the integer, but I have to find the real number. Then real number means can. Now the solution of example 5. Example number 5. Solve for 7x plus 3, 5x plus 9. So the graph. You have to sum it 7x plus 3, 5x plus 9. First of all, you should remove 5x in both the sides. Therefore, I can write it as 7x plus 3 minus 5x, 5x minus 5x plus 9. Okay, then 5x, 7x minus 5x, 2x plus 3, this is cancelled, 5, 9. Now we have to remove 3 plus 3, therefore we can write it as x, 2x plus 3 minus 3, 9 minus 3. I can delete it. Two x six x less than 6/2 means 3. The solution is x less than 3. You have to show on the real number line. Let us suppose this is 0, 1, 2, 3 in the positive direction, in the negative direction, -1, -2, -3, -4. Less than 3 means what? It will not start from 3. It will beyond 3 means this will not improve. This will be open. And from here to all the numbers will be improved. In the negative side, all the numbers will improve. Okay? This is the graph. It will be open. 3. 3 will, 3 will not be included. And after 3, all numbers will be the solution of yes. Understood?